I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do.
It's now late October and I've been building quite steadily, chopping up logs, sawing them logs into planks, going on nail runs and stuff like that. And I've managed to build the third tower in the top left hand corner of the safe zone. And I've unfortunately haven't got space to actually build a fourth corner tower, like a watchtower. So I've started actually building Tenpenny Tower, we'll call it Tenpenny Tower, which is the biggest tower that's going to overwatch the whole of the safe zone and all that good stuff. And that's going to take quite a while. I'm not even too sure if I have enough nails to build it the way that I want to build it. I've exhausted a lot of the trees and logs from around the base as well. And at the moment, I'm just taking a sledgehammer to all this stuff in the church. And this is going to be the armory. I'm going to store weapons, backpacks, axes, hammers and stuff like that here. Anything that can be used on loot runs is going to be here for myself and the other citizens of Alexandria. And you know, they can come here before they go out on loot runs, kind of arm up and then head out. So I thought I'd just clear all this kind of churchy shit out of here. And yeah, churchy shit, I'm not too sure what that is. But I'm going to build some crates, build some shelves and stuff in here and store all the weapons and ammunition that I've found off dead bodies, dead zombies and, you know, kind of looting and stuff like that. So, you know, all going pretty well at the moment and all that good stuff. And this is the start of the tower, just right here. So it's going up a few floors. I do want to go up probably another, maybe five, if I've got the time and the resources to do so. But I'm going to have to get my axe, get my saw, and start lacing up this armory with some shelving and continue building the tower as well. Quite a bit of time has passed and I've managed to kind of further the building of the tower, just on the top of it here. And I've also managed to get quite a bit of the storage facility stuff into the church armory as well. Didn't think I'd ever be saying them two words together. And let's just head there now. Walking like a bit of a chode, you know? Bit of a chode. Don't even know which fucking direction I'm going in. Right, let's just pop in here and have a look. It's actually, is that a burnt fence? I think that's a burnt part of the wall there, which could be a problem. But this is all the shelving and stuff. We've got some shit in here. You know, I've moved some axes in here, and we've got the pistols that I've found, the bullets that I've collected, and all that good stuff. We've got a specialist shotgun shelf, which is very nice indeed. And I've also been doing some farming as well, just in between. Just managed to dig all this stuff up. So I've got a bit of farmland going. I've managed to dig up some of the long grass, clear up a lot of the kind of shitty blood and stuff like that. Obviously there is still different parts elsewhere. But, you know, I've got some stuff planted and that's going to stop me hammering through my kind of non-perishable goods, as I'm going to just be able to eat cabbage and shit like a rabbit for a few weeks, which is good. You know, everyone loves Nesquik and stuff like that. And what I'm going to do now, as I've got quite a few empty bottles and the actual water has gone off. The water has gone off. And I'm just going to fill this up. So let's just fill that cooking pot. And then I'm going to have to boil this so it's not tainted and pour this into all the different water bottles that I have. So I've got some purified or distilled water. Probably purified, I think. So let's just chuck that on there. Where are we? A pot of water. So that's actually tainted at the moment, which is a bit of a problem. As I did build that water catcher, I didn't think that rainwater would be that tinted, but I suppose it must be if there's like Zeds and disease in the sea and it's, you know, going round and round and all that kind of weird shit. So let's just go and have a quick look at these new lights. I did actually manage to find some ropes and some flashlights popped out for a day or so ago, just around a few houses and all that good stuff as well, which is pretty decent indeed. So let's have a look. Pot of water, magical stuff. Should just be able to pour this in. Let's just turn this barbecue off. Okay, so if I just pour this into the empty bottles, and then I should be good to go. Should be able to hydrate whenever necessary. And yeah, going pretty well at the moment. Need to keep building and try and further the safety of the whole safe zone thing. I've just been building at night, and unfortunately I've managed to fall off the top of the tower into the lower floor. And there we go, a left thigh fracture. So, oh shit, this is bad. I haven't got an incredible amount of first aid stuff either, so this could be really, really, really bad. Just gonna equip my axe just to... Can I make a splint out of this? Shit, this is pretty critical stuff, I'm afraid. Oh no, shit, I think I need a tree branch and some rip sheets. There should be some tree branches downstairs from all the kind of log cutting I've done, which have fallen off logs, obviously, and trees. And up until now, everything was going pretty well, but moderate damage, this is pretty bad indeed. Right, I'm just going to bandage that just for the time being. And that's going to do an incredible amount, but shit, that's a pretty bad fracture as well. To fracture your thigh. I mean, it's a pretty big bone. Right, twigs. Can I use twigs? Nope. Come on, where are we? Come on, come on. Bit of blood there as well. OCD's going mental. Right, there we go, tree branch. Right, I should be able to splint this. I make splint. Okay, and then... let's take the bandage off. And I think I can just put the splint on, splint this up. And this is going to be me out of the game for a while. Good job I did some farming earlier, because I've got some stuff growing, but... Jesus, look at the speed. Look at that speed. Like a fucking Speedy Gonzales. Oh shit, the bed. This is bad. I'm pretty badly injured as well. I'm almost certain I haven't got any painkillers. In fact, I'm 110% sure I haven't got any painkillers. Because I was thinking, wow, this is strange. I haven't found any painkillers. Fuck. Fuck, fuck, fuck. I mean, the tower's getting on as well. The tower's doing pretty well. Just, like, I kind of fell through it, which was pretty bad. That's not what you want to be doing. I can't exactly go out either at this pace. It's going to tie me, and I'm not going to be able to get away from any Zeds. So, I think I'm going to have to wait this out. Just maybe try and farm or something like that. But this is fucking bad. This is really, really bad. It's now the next day, and even though I can't walk properly, I've decided to take this opportunity to actually explore, like, the rest of the houses in Alexandria. I've kind of scoped them a bit and kind of skim-read the shelves, but I haven't actually managed to look intensively at everything and kind of scour through stuff. So, you know, this is going to help me pick up little odds and sods and shit like that that's around, and there shouldn't be any Zeds about. Let's just take that. And, you know, I should be fairly safe, even though I can't walk properly. So, I think it's some of these northern houses that I haven't actually checked. Let's just head on up. Okay, let's check this one. I don't even know if I've opened some of these doors. Really need to get rid of some of these wall vines. Make it look like The Last of Us or something. Okay, just close that behind us, just in case. I mean, there could actually be Zeds around here, as I haven't opened up every single room. So I've still got to be fairly cautious, but, you know, definitely haven't got any painkillers. Also looking for painkillers, if I can find them, that's going to aid me. Let's take these seeds. I'm going to do a bit more farming later, as I cannot do anything else. What else have we got? Tomato seeds, strawberry seeds, Chardonnay? No. I think, yeah, you know, I could just get absolutely shit-faced off, like, wine and whiskey. You know, just hammer my liver to death, and, you know, that's a painkiller, isn't it? Alcohol's a very good painkiller. Let's just stay cautious. There we go. Okay, pistol. Might as well chuck that in. That can go in the armory. And I think it's just a case of grabbing everything good. I will actually redistribute all the items and goods to any survivors that actually managed to make it to Alexandria. I do hope to build up some more weapon stuff, like get some hunting rifles, some environment rifle, and all that good stuff. Probably just said that extremely wrong. What else we got? Fuck all in there. I mean, there isn't actually an extreme amount. I was hoping to find painkillers. There's sleeping tablets everywhere, which are good, because I do need to sleep a lot to kind of heal this up. This could take anywhere between maybe a month and fuck knows how long. God knows. Right, let's see what else we got on here. Disinfectant. We'll take that as well, just in case I get any scratches. I've got a tendency to smash windows. And we'll fill the water bottle from the toilet, get some of that chalky water in there. I think the only kind of bright side to being injured, or like horrifically injured, is the fact that I've actually managed to get some decent farming done. And the key to kind of healing quickly is to eat a shitload, you know, like feeding the cold and stuff like that. So these are actually ready to harvest cabbages at the moment, but I think if I leave them a tiny bit longer, they're going to be seed bearing. I think maybe, I don't know the process, but they seem to carry seeds later on, maybe when they kind of like, I don't know. I really don't know. They get seeds later on, you know, it's one of them things. So I'm just going to plant some radishes, shit like that. And I think I'm going to head out and actually build some animal traps as well later on. I'm not too sure what bait to use out of what I've got. I mean, I haven't got any meat or anything like that, so it might have to be strawberries or cabbages or radishes or some type of fruit or vegetable, or certainly vegetable anyway. And try and catch some, like, rats or rabbit or whatever. And, you know, never know. Might be able to get some good stuff and eat some, like, dead rat burger or something. Just heading out to actually set these traps, to actually build and set these traps. I think you need 3 planks and a nail for each. And I've got some strawberries on me as bait, as that's kind of the best thing that I can conjure up. So I'm going to set a few outside. I've got 2 there and a few inside as well. Let's go do the one here, I think. And I think depending on where I place the trap, that's different to what I'm going to catch. So like round houses and stuff, it's going to be mice and rats. And then I think outdoors, kind of out of the Alexandria walls, so to speak, there's a lot of kind of rural countrysidey kind of forestry. I think forestry is going to be the word. And I should be able to catch some rabbit or something good like that, which should be a decent hearty meal, as opposed to eating cabbages and shitting myself dry. And, you know, need some meat in that shit. Let's de-liquefy and, you know, get all that good stuff. I mean, too much roughage from that amount of veg. 5 a day's one thing and, you know, 15 a day's another. So let's just go down the sheep rope. Should be all right to climb this with a broken thigh, I think. Maybe it's climbing up, which could be the problem. There we go. All right, okay, so let's just set this kind of further inset into the forestry. Probably somewhere here, I think. There we go. Let's just place that down. Probably there. I'm not too sure if I have to camouflage it or anything like that, or if noises affect what I catch, but let's just add some strawberries under the trap and I can start checking them in a few days' time. It's pretty nice having the luxury to kind of not have to kind of rely on the trap and stuff. I've got the fishing lake, which seems to be pretty dry at the moment. I did actually try and fish quite a few days ago. It's now actually November, and I didn't get absolutely anything at all. I got a sock and a pair of shoes, I think, which is unfortunately not edible. So let's just place another trap here with them planks. And hopefully I'm going to be healed soon, because this is just dull, like really, really fucking dull. Add some strawberries to that as well. And I think in hindsight, I'm going to have to go out, and I believe there's a hospital to the South Island, which is where I'm going to go and try and get some medical supplies once I am fully patched up and ready to go. But we will see. Let's just take a quick look around. All the trees are growing back pretty quickly. Pretty quickly indeed. Not that I can move anything at the moment, though. It's now late November, and I can fucking run again and walk properly like a real man. I've actually still got this splint on, and when I take it off, I've still got a fracture, so I'm not too sure why I've got the ability to run. Maybe it's like Forrest Gump, you know, maybe it'll just like fall off when I'm sprinting. People will be like, run, Forrest, blah, 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 and stuff like that. So let's just get the weapons. I'm going to head down to the hospital now. It's 10:40 in the morning. And, you know, all going well. I'm just checking this burn thing out. And that could be a problem if any Zeds do get in, so I'm going to have to sledge that down and kind of patch that up. Let's just grab the old tasty. Fucking stuttering now. Just put my trowel in there for a second. Take some shotgun shells. I think the problem is I haven't actually got any beta blockers either, and I'm a kind of nervous wreck. I'm panicked quite a lot of the time, which is pretty bad. Let's just chuck the trowel into here. Where are we? Throw a worm in there as well. Could use that for fishing bait. I've not actually used any worms. I've got probably the best part of about 50 worms from all the digging I've done. But I'll have to use them for fishing as bait. I've just been using fish and tackle. Right, what have we got? No. Shit. Okay, none in there either. So, that's a bit of a shame. Just gotta close this door. Don't want any Zeds coming in. If they do creep in, maybe they learn how to use sheet ropes or something. And I'm just gonna check the traps that I actually put down. I did actually put a few more down in here. Where are they? Down there. Okay, let's check this one. No, there's fuck all in there, I don't think. That's a bit of a shame. I can't seem to check it properly. That's a bit weird. Maybe it's because there is actually nothing in there. I assume the thing would fall, the kind of little latch post thing. But I'll have to check the two outside, and I think it's quite a long run to the hospital, so I might actually have to stay the night. I've got to cross the river by going across the bridge south of the garage, I believe. Which is where I started some fires quite a while ago. And be interesting to see what damage that's done as well, if I do make it back. There's nothing in that one as well. This is worrying. Worrying shit indeed. Let's just check this last one and then head down. There is some grass there, though. I'll leave that there. It camos a bit. You know, camouflage the trap and all that good stuff. So I'm just at the hospital. And I think this is the hospital anyway. Yeah, it is the hospital. There's quite a bit of Zed attention around. Just need to get my shotgun out because, you know, I love my shotgun. I'm going to have to use it. And, shit. I didn't get time to actually fucking equip and reload it, especially with being so panicked. Probably should have reloaded it or loaded it kind of before I left. But, you know, hindsight's an incredible thing. Oh, shit, the bed. Right. Might have to loop round. Just looking for an open door or access way. I'm pretty shit at opening windows as well, so this could be a bit of a problem. Might have to even camp in one of the houses for the evening and then come back with a loaded shotgun. Well, that's going to be a pretty bad idea. I've got a feeling there are quite a few Zeds. In fact, fuck it, this window looks good. Yeah, it's double layered. Go through it, smash this. There we go. Hopefully don't get caught. Magical. Right, come on. Shit, just close up behind. Oh, fuck. Fucking hell. Close quarters combat with tiredness or exhaustion's pretty bad. Right, just get my shotgun out and let's do this properly. Fucking hell. Must be shaking like a shitting dog. Just put my axe in my backpack as well. Ooh. Just to lighten the load slightly. And let's just get a box of shells out. Ooh, not three boxes, just the one, hopefully. I mean, hopefully I won't even have to use this. I might use it tactically if I do get out on the way back to draw more Zeds down here from other areas and maybe even away from my base. And it kind of works, hopefully. Hopefully it works anyway. We'll see. That's even if I get out alive. But what's this, like a waiting room or something? Okay, what have we got here? Cool. Right, okay. I really want to go in anywhere until I've got a fully loaded gun. Okay, what have we got? What have we got? Pretty nice hospital. I think this was private care, you know, this wasn't like kind of government hospital. Right, it's gonna be fuck all in there, unfortunately. Ooh, looks like a conference room or something. That was the weirdest reaction to a conference room ever. Ah, magical. Right, there seems to be a decent amount of stuff in it. Okay. Antidepressants, beta blockers. I'm just going to take them now. I'll try and calm myself down. Let's take as many of them as I possibly can. Some painkillers as well. And take some alcohol wipes. You know, just in case we get hemorrhoids. Not that I think they actually help with hemorrhoids, but, you know, what can you do? I'm not a doctor and all that. Take some more antidepressants. I mean, I've got a bit of a habit for eating non-fresh fruit, which is a really depressing thing to do. Just sitting there, slugging away in fucking rotten tomatoes or something. So, antidepressants are a bit of a winner as far as I'm concerned. Right, I'm not going out that way, as that's the way out. What have we got here? No, there doesn't seem to be anything there either. Okay. I don't even know whether to kind of go through any further after this without sleeping. If I can find somewhere to sleep. Ooh, we'll take that flashlight. Should be able to actually put some new lights up. I did actually find some rope a while ago before I broke my leg. Found a bit of rope and, you know, a few first aid kits and stuff like that, which is pretty good. Even though the first aid kits are pretty useless at the moment. Especially when you're looking for decent medication and painkillers and stuff like that. Right, what have we got in here? Right, okay, I think this is where I'm actually going to spend the night and sleep. There's a counter there which is going to block off any Zeds as well. And I'll resume my medication run in the morning. I've been up for a few hours and I'm just getting some last stuff together before I head back. I could really, really do with some food actually. Pretty hungry and stupidly didn't bring anything out with me. Which is pretty bad, pretty silly. And stuff like that. There's nothing of any note in any of these kind of drawers. I think these are just kind of private wards and stuff like that. Oh shit. Okay, let's just check this one. Seems to be a lot more effective at kind of sneaking around. I want to leave that pistol there, by the way. I have got, like, an abundance of pistols now. Seems to be extremely common. Oh, shit. Fuck. Fuck, I miss. Right, there we go. Problem solved. Let's just fucking reload and close that door. And hopefully I can find some medication in here. And once I've got that together, you know, I can just go and head back. Right, there we go. Awesome. Okay, beta blockers, painkillers. Yes, please. Let's take some more painkillers. Antidepressants. Medication seems really rare around New Denver. So, it's always good. I can always come back down here. And all that good stuff. So, antidepressants there. Alcohol wipes. Got a lot of disinfectant back at the base as well. So, don't really need to kind of burden myself with carrying that back. Right, what have we got here? Oh, I thought this was a cafeteria. I think it's just like a conference room or a staff room or something. Maybe it's a cafeteria, just a really, really shit cafeteria. Which is, you know, equally as bad. You know, shit cafeterias are really shit and extremely pointless. So, fuck cafeterias. Okay, I think it's probably time to head back. Let's just check these last few rooms. What have we got there? Nah. What about this one? Okay. Nah. Not at all. Right, I think I've got everything that I actually do need now, so it's time to go. I could do with some food. It's like I'm pretty weighed down. Shitload of Zeds. And yeah, this is pretty bad. Quite a few Zeds. Hopefully these don't follow me back up. I'm not too sure how resistant my walls are. Probably not that resistant at all, in fact. But let's just check what we've got. What's in this bin? Nothing in the bin. Get into here. Oh, fucking hell. So shit at opening windows, just thrusting against it. Oh, the fucking door's open. Obviously, the fucking door's open. Okay. Oh, nice. Nice, nice, nice. Okay. Let's take some of this. Eat some popcorn. Canned carrots. Very nice indeed. The more food I can take back, the better, because then I don't have to go out on any more runs and stuff like that. Corned beef. Holy shit. Didn't realise it was treat day. Right, let's take some more of that shit. What else we got? Anything else? Nothing in the bin either. Shite. I'm just going to eat some chips just to get my energy up slightly. Only very slightly. Right, there we go. And that's going to allow me to sprint slightly quicker through the power of chips. Don't know what flavour they were, but probably a winning flavour. And I might actually fire off a few shots here. There we go. Might seem a bit strange. I'm just trying to actually attract Zeds to this area, as this is quite a distance away from my actual base. So the more Zeds down here and the more Zeds away from me up top, then, you know, the better. That's always a winner. Just going to take some beta blockers as well. Calm me down, as I'm running with a turtle head at the moment, and, you know, that slows you down massively. Is there anything around? Seem to be fairly clear. Hopefully they've all kind of headed south, and they're all not along this road as well. Oh, shit. Oh, what have we got here? Nice little garage. Houses are really nice. Really, really nice houses. Right, I'm nearly home free. Nearly home free. I'm just going to try and get a tiny bit more food. I believe there's like a garage or some kind of convenience store nearby to here. So if I can get there, it should be good to go and all that good shit. Right, okay, I think this is it. Yeah, it looks like a garage. And I should be able to get some chips and maybe some more water bottles or something from here. Let's see if I can get in. All the Zeds have seemed to have kind of headed south, which is really nice. Just need to, fuck, double check, see if there's anything around. Never be too sure. Right, let's try this again. Yeah, they seem to have all headed kind of south. And that's pretty good news for me. Pretty good news indeed. Okay, what else we got? Right, orange soda, I'll take that shit. And that as well. It's pretty good in case you're running low on food. Just use that shit. And, you know, it's going to fill you up. All the fizzy bubbles, like Keenan and Kel or whatever. Was it Keenan or Kel? One that was obsessed with orange soda. And all that shit. So, oh, for fuck's sake. Right, I'm just going to eat them chips. Again, another energy boost off unhealthy food. Right, I'm going to have to put these in my main inventory. My backpack's pretty full at the moment. Probably all the medication and stuff like that. But ideally, if any survivors do turn up, then, you know, everyone can have, like, farmer duties and stuff like that. And you get a massive kind of crop rotation on the go and stuff, and it'll be pretty good. It's quite hard doing shit on your lonesome, boo-hoo, etc. But, yeah, backpack's pretty full at the moment. Let's just see what else we've got. Orange soda's pretty heavy. Pretty heavy indeed. Maybe it's like them massive, like, gangster bottles. I don't know what they're called. What we've got in the fridge. Oh, burger. Oh. I need to find a cow. Fucking leather a cow. Just beat a cow to death with my bare hands. It's pretty nice that the kind of zombie corpses are leading the way home. Almost like a kind of arrows. Like directions. Like leaving the border strings. Is that fire still going? Fuck. That was about 2 months ago. Maybe 6 weeks ago, tops. And the fire's still going. Jesus. Just take a few of these out. This shelf's probably a fucking bad idea, actually. How the fuck is this fire still going? Maybe, like, all the Zeds have walked through here and migrated or whatever, and I don't know. That's just baffling. I came down with a gas can, what I had left of a gas can. I burned quite a few, but they seem to have perished, and the fire's still going. That is remarkable. Absolutely remarkable, but nearly home now, and managed to get all the stuff back intact. So I think what I'm going to do is just spend the next few weeks trying to finish the tower and stuff like that, and hopefully can get it done without falling off and breaking every limb and, you know, shattering my penis and stuff by falling on the floor, because, you know, that's plausible. If you've got a porcelain penis. But we will see. We'll see what happens. And hopefully I can get it done safely. And then go up probably looking for survivors and stuff like that. I might have to go to West Point and Muldrow. But, you know, we will see. It's now about 3 weeks later. And I've managed to finish Tenpenny Tower off. And I got a tiny bit of farming done last night as well, just to tidy up the place. I do need to move all these corpses and stuff like that. But this is the third watchtower. in this corner. So, you know, all getting there. The sheet rope, same as the others. And I think this one's actually a bit wider. I actually did that by mistake. Dimensions are slightly different, but no real bother, really. You know, good view of the beach and stuff like that. And all that good stuff. And I've actually more or less ran out of nails. I've got about 30 left and was hoping to build some kind of safe area to fish in. Just off this little coastal bit. Kind of joining up to the kind of fort walls. But I might have to put that on hold for a bit until I do find some more nails. This was the bit of farming I did last night. Just, you know, went around digging and stuff like that. And there's a pile of Zeds. Moved a few of them. The old gas can storage there. And I managed to fill in the armory wall with two walls as well. And this is Tenpenny Tower. So this is about 7 floors up. It does actually get smaller and smaller. I thought it'd actually look a lot better, but I can put some tents, some storage in here as well. And, you know, if this place gets overrun, then hopefully this will work as a kind of decent, I don't know, decent shelter from all that, really. Or something along those lines, I'm not too sure. Maybe a kind of like safe house in the safe zone. Yeah, that works. Why not? That'll do. And here we go. This is the top. Obviously, Spiffo there. So it's quite high up. Looks a bit like a Viennetta and stuff like that. But it's going pretty well. And I think I'm going to have to start looking for survivors pretty soon in the surrounding areas. Help them, you know, give them houses. And hopefully we can all build this stuff together. Build upon this. Better. Hopefully they can bring some more flashlights and some rope and some nails and stuff. If any of them come from West Point and Muldrow and stuff like that. But I think what I have to do in the next few days is just basically finish up boarding everywhere up and go and find some nails as well. And, you know, all that good stuff. And just get everything ready. Give every house a farming area, a water barrel and stuff like that. But, you know, that depends on finding garbage bags and nails. So, thanks for watching, guys. And I will see you soon.